This is a 2005 Toyota Sienna with a 3.3-liter 3MZ-FE engine. This vehicle has been a frequent visitor to our shop recently. First, we had to replace the coolant overflow reservoir that goes over here on the front of the radiator with an aftermarket unit. And then we had to replace the thermostat that is down here tucked into the valley between the two cylinder banks. And in this video, I'm going to tell you about the latest coolant system disaster that struck this vehicle only a few days after we did these repairs. This is the original thermostat housing for this vehicle. The thermostat housing goes on the engine in this position right here. And to the left side, which is the front of the vehicle, it goes into the lower radiator hose. And look at what happened to this tube. This tube is made of a plastic nylon aramid composite. And it was just fine when we replaced the thermostat. Then when we put it back on, it crumbled away like this after a few days of running the engine. The 3.3-liter 3MZ-FE uses a plastic composite housing, but the 1MZ uses a good old-fashioned metal housing. The metal housing from the 1MZ is a direct fit on the 3MZ. So I took an old housing from an engine that I had sitting around and I put it onto this vehicle. It is a direct fit. So I don't know what was the intention with using a plastic thermostat housing. This is a design flaw that afflicts a lot of vehicles, in particular Fords and Mazdas with Ecotec or whatever tech engine that they have. They all have thermostat housing that just crumble and have to be replaced. And we would have thought that Toyota would not let themselves be lulled into this same trap of who knows, whatever the intention is, cost savings or weight reduction. We don't know. Whatever it is, it's a bad idea. By the way, this is a very well-maintained vehicle. It's had its timing belt and water pump service done. It has all new hoses and belts, or newer at least. It has ice-cold AC. The braking system is in great condition. It has a newer radiator replaced within the last couple of years. And a newer battery replaced 2 years ago. And it has a newer starter and newer alternator, and this runs without any check engine lights or any other issues. The owner loves this minivan and wants to keep it running. The cost of these repairs is less than the cost of ownership of a newer car, and especially when you factor in my friends and family rates that I give to my favorite customers. You would be very hard-pressed to find a vehicle of this age with a better service history. I had some self-appointed internet idiot comment on a previous video that this is obviously not a well-maintained vehicle. Well, I already said what I think of that guy. Hope you enjoyed this video and thanks for watching.